we were sort of running all the sheep together and you'd get them in at scanning and some would be twins, some would be singles and some would be dry, and you'd just sort of think, you know, why does that happen?
I'm Clayton South. I farm with my partner Polly and three young boys, 30 k's east of Wagin. We've got a mixed cropping and livestock farm on 4,000 hectares with myself and two full-time employees. Probably cropping 65-70% of the farm each year, with the remainder being livestock. We make 6,500 adult ewes annually, and then 1,000 ewe lambs on top of that as well. 2.5 years ago, we were looking at moving into EID, so we went and purchased a Tapari Racewell sheep handler with an EID panel reader, weigh scale. We've also bought a Gallagher stick reader, so we can actually, you know, read tags at the yards where we don't have to cart the handler around. We wanted to record each animal's preg status each year, so twin, single or dry, and then be able to sort of follow that through and see if our twins were becoming sort of repeat twinners. These are the tags we're using. They're just made by Allflex. They're completely NLIS compliant. Tracking the growth rates on the young sheep, there's no way we would even attempt it without the tags. These eyes activate and close the clamp. Okay, on the back there's the panel reader, so that'll actually read the animal's tag, send that up to this little box, which will then Bluetooth it across to this box. So that'll recognise the animal, and then we can have whatever data, on that animal, previous data that we've captured, all stays in here. So we're actually recording the weight and growth rates while still doing, you know, our normal husbandry operations. It's just finding out those better performing animals. So, I mean, they come in, they've been running the same paddock, same feed, same everything, and some cut, you know, 5 kilos of wool and some might cut 2 kilos of wool. So try and find those better performing animals. One, breed from those, and two, remove those poorer performing ones from the flock. We think it's giving its value. So to sit down with Peter and really go through it was good.
It was an interesting challenge because there's really three separate components to what they're doing. First of all, you had the pregnancy scanning, then you had the lamb weighing, and then finally you had the fleece weighing. And we had to build all three of them together. So from the South's investment of $34,500, they were getting a return of about $92,000 over 10 years. Or $3.50 for each dollar they invest, and the payback was occurring over about 6 years. Looking at it economically, it makes sense for the Souths to invest in the EID.
It's probably lambs on the ground for us is the key. So we want a high fertile animal that can produce, you know, two good lambs really. The technology and stuff that is going to be around in the next sort of 5 or 10 years is sort of fairly exciting around EID, so I think it's been a good investment.
The Department of Primary Industries and Regional Development, through its Sheep Industry Business Innovation Project, made possible by royalties for regions, is supporting and sharing new technologies in the sheep industry. This is improving labour efficiency in the sector and making it easier all round to run sheep.